Hello everyone, my name is JMLisondra and today I'm gonna teach you how to paint this wonderful painting by only using limited colors my palette. And don't forget to subscribe, yep, subscribe it, and please don't forget to hit that bell button if you want to know my latest videos in the future.
Before I'm going to start the tutorial, I'm going to introduce to you first the materials that I'm going to use. So I still be using limited colors my palette, and I have the titanium white, the hollow blue, the brilliant red, the medium, medium yellow, the brilliant red, and the raw umber. So I'm using limited colors in my palette because I want you to learn to mix and get the desired colors you want. Okay, so I'll be using the following brushes. So I have here then the number 12 nylon flat brush long handle, and I also have here the number 8 nylon flat brush long handle. I also have here the number 8 nylon flat brush short handle, and we have here the number 1 liner brush for the details. You can also use 0, double zeros, and triple zeros. Okay, so those are just the possible brushes that I'm gonna use for this tutorial, and I'm not sure if I'm gonna use all of it, but I'm sure I will. Okay, and this is my canvas. It's 10 by 12 inches with a 3 coats of prime white acrylic and a Swiss chisel. I made it myself, and we need water to thin the paint and water spray if we're gonna need to wet our canvas, and it will be easier for us to blend the colors. Okay, so today I'm gonna paint an old rustic padlock on an old door or fence. Okay, so the photo is from Pixabay, so if you want a royalty free photos, you can download it from Pixabay, so you don't worry about copyright. Okay, so I'm gonna start now, and I'm gonna start it with a little sketching. I'm gonna use first the number 8 flat brush long handle, and it's gonna do a little sketch first. So I'll be using the raw umber and the white, mix it with white so that it will become a little grayish, and it will be easier for us to cover it with other colors. Okay, so we're going to divide it first here at the center. I'm gonna put the padlock, the metal lock here. The look will be something like this. So if you're gonna need some adjustments, I'm gonna do it later. So I think I'm gonna make it a little bigger. I'm gonna do the adjustment now. And this will be the padlock. This will be a trial and error method, so I'm gonna make it a little bigger again. Should be some sort of circle here, and I'm gonna make the hole bigger here. So this will be a trial and error method, everyone. There. Okay, so the color of the fence will be, or the door will be, it has some bluish paint or blue paint there, so I'm gonna paint it with blue color. Okay, so I'm gonna use this blue here and white with a little yellow to make it, this will be a little bluish green, so blue green. So I forgot to clean my brush. You should clean your brush from time to time. So we're gonna mix the two colors here, blue green. Okay, this is quite a dirty blue green. I'll be using the bigger brush, so I think we're gonna mix again. You can dip the tip of your brush into the water to make it a little wet, and it will be easier for you to blend or to blend, okay, or to blend it in the canvas, so it will be a little lighter. So don't worry if you cover some parts of your sketch. Just remember where you're putting it. And also on the color of the rustic lock. I'm not really sure what you call this one. So it's a rustic lock. It is the metal lock. Part of the metal lock. Okay. So here, I'm gonna add a little darker colors. So we need to fill this part with the color, and also here. There, okay. And also here, I'm gonna try to fill this part with everything, with every color. There you go. Okay, so I'm going back to the brush, to the number 8 flat brush long handle. I'm gonna clean it first, and I'm gonna use this raw umber with red and white. So So I'm gonna color it with a rustic color. And also here, I'm gonna color it with rustic brown. This will be a part of the wood which was built and it has no paint on it. So I'm gonna put it, I'm gonna color it brown. And this will be the big hole here, black hole, big black hole. And I'm gonna change my brush for a smaller one, which is the number 8 Nylon flat brush, short handle. And I'm gonna mix with another brown. Okay. Okay, we're gonna retouch that later if something seems not good. Okay, so I'm gonna use this umber, and I'm gonna put some shades here. At the bottom, using the umber only. I don't use black here, everyone. And I'm gonna make this bottom dark using the raw umber. Okay. And I'm gonna use this again. The brown. Cause I'm gonna put some part of the lock here. Part of the center. And then I'm mixing red and yellow to make some orange. And I'm going to create a circle here. I'm not really sure what they call this one, but it's just a part of the details of the rustic metal. And I'm going to put a little more detail. Okay, now I'll be using some lighter brown. I think this orange, when is this orange? I'm gonna put some rust. More orange. I'm gonna put more rust. Okay. Yeah, it's a little dry. And I'll be using a smaller brush now. This is the number one liner brush for a further mold, smaller details. So I'm gonna use this raw umber. So I'm gonna put a darker shadow here. Gonna put some shades to make this one more realistic. Yeah. There. I am now starting to put details on this one. Okay, because the paint's really dry. So here I'm gonna put some black. Some parts are still dry, but I think I can handle that now. It's actually the problem when the camera is in front of you, it's really hard to move. Okay, there. And make this part darker. And also here, I'm gonna put some shades. Okay. And then also here. So that's the gap of the wood. Or between the wood, sorry everyone. And also here. I'm gonna put another gap. Okay, that looks nice. Okay, so it's gonna start to put more tiny details. Okay, so I'll be using, no, I think I'm gonna put details here first. I think shadow. So I'll be using the blue and the yellow, more blue. To put some shadow on the padlock, on the wood. So here, I'm gonna put some white first to make it a little lighter. And here. So I think some parts still wet, but I can handle this, and I can add some more details later on. So I'm gonna add blue and yellow. I want it to be a little darker. So this is actually a casted shadow, everyone. So if ever you are wondering why I have this dark bluish color here. So this is a casted shadow. And also here. I'm gonna darken this part. Okay. Green and blue. And white. And also here we're gonna put a casted shadow. You can choose any color like blue, greenish or bluish green. So I'm using the bluish green color instead of more blue color. So here, let a little shade, and also here. Then, also need to put some casted shadow on this part. And then another one here. Okay, that's it. We have now some shades or shadows. Then we're gonna start adding more details. I'm gonna do it first on the padlock. So I'll be using this light orange. No, this light brown first. And white. I'm gonna mix for a lighter color. I'm gonna make it way lighter. And also here. Touch it. And I'm gonna brain it a little with some orange. All you have to do is to keep blending. even it's not that blend well, it doesn't matter. Okay, so here I have another yellow and red. I want more orange. So we're gonna make the rust more visible, like putting an orange color. I'm gonna put more shades, no more orange first. So I'm gonna put more white and yellow. Okay, so I'll be putting more shade, so using the brown, raw umber, red and yellow, so it will be a little darker brown. And here, I'm gonna make it this part a little darker. There. So, and in here, so we need more shadings, everyone. That's all we need to do to make the painting look more realistic. Just add more shadings, details, as many as you can. That's why if you are going to give more time on your painting, the more time you give, the better the output will become. So because we're gonna put more details on it, and that details will make it look more realistic. And then I'm gonna use this raw umber. To add a clear details here. So I'll just make it this part darker. Yes. Okay. There. Well, so far it looks good. Okay, so I think I'm gonna use a little bigger brush now. I'll be using the number 8 flat brush. I'm gonna put some more details. So here I'm gonna use this darker green color to add more stains. Okay, so we're gonna continue adding some more details with this darker greenish bluish tone. Actually, if I'm going to seriously put all the needed details here, I think I'm gonna finish it in 1 month or in many hours. Not 1 month, but I mean many hours. So if you are painting, everyone, I want you to put plenty of time finishing that painting, because it's really important to do your best on that painting. And the more details you put there, the better it will always become. So I encourage you to do that on any of your paintings. I'm gonna put some blue stone there. Blue. Just a little tiny fractions of stains. That's very important. Okay, I'm gonna add some browns. So here I'm gonna use the raw umber. Oh, the red, the raw umber, and the yellow. I'll be putting more stains here. There. Okay. But of course not enough, everyone, so I'm gonna put more. This time it will be more brownish, so I'm gonna use the umber with a little white. More brownish. Okay. Just plenty of stains out there. That's it. Yeah, that looks, for me, realistic. Even if it's not done yet. There will be plenty of details here I'm gonna put. Maybe I will finish it offline with lots of details. This one will actually look more impressionistic, but I still love it. It still look realistic for me. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So. I will be putting more darker tones, dark umber. And also here. Okay. Well, that looks nice. So maybe I'll retouch the padlock. I'm gonna make this one smooth. I'm gonna use more gray and white. There. And then I'm gonna put more blue. Because I'm gonna make this part darker. This one also. Okay. One more retouch. Try here. Okay. Yeah. And then I'm gonna put some blue stone. So I'm gonna use this blue and white. So we're gonna put some blue stone also. Some stains of blue. Maybe more. I want it lighter. There. The more details you put, the better it will look. So you just have to create stains of multiple colors. Even if it's not that smooth, it will actually still look realistic because of the stains, amount of stains of colors you're putting on the details. So here I'm gonna put some blue stains. more blue stains. I'm gonna try to put some bluish color. Some tiny stains of blue on the shades. There. Yeah. Yeah, I think I'm almost done. So I'm going to add more colors, I guess. So I'm gonna use this white first. Try to put some more details. Okay, so that's just what we need to do for the entire process. Adding stains of colors, different colors there. Okay. Yeah. I'm gonna make this part darker, so I'm gonna mix for blue and yellow, more blue and white. And also here. More bluish and yellow and white. I'm going to create vertical strokes and make sure that the great textures on that part. Yeah, even if it's not that smooth, as long as there's textures, you can see textures in there. Okay, so I've done it in 1 hour. So here I'm gonna put some more highlights. Yeah, okay, so I think I am done, everyone. So this is the first step, and I think I'm gonna do the retouching on offline. So for now, for the tutorial, this will be good for everyone. So this is how you're gonna paint an old padlock and an old door. So thank you. So if you have some questions, you can put it in the comment box below. So here we're just doing some impressionistic style, but still look realistic for me. So just how can I easy doing this one in just 1 hour.
Okay everyone, so I wanna say thank you for watching this video today, and I hope you get something out of this. And my only advice is to keep on practicing, keep on painting. The more you do it, the more you know how to use your brush, the more you will know how to mix the colors. That's why I'm using limited colors in my palette, because I want you to learn how to mix and get the desired colors you want. So please hit like and some comments, subscribe for more videos in the future. Okay, once again, thank you. Have a nice day, and God bless you all. All the glory and honor and praises always belongs to the Lord.